Hey everyone, Steven Sitkowski here, leading educator on teaching people how to trade the financial markets. So today we're going to do lesson 101. Why should you be interested in the stock market? So I want to give you a little bit of a historical perspective. So if we go back to 1900 and we look at average rates of return, now keep in mind we had the crash of 1929, we have up markets, we have down markets. But if we were to flatten all of that out, smooth it, and say, okay, what can we expect out of the market? Bottom line is, somewhere in the neighborhood of about an 8% per year return. And if you know anything about the rule of 72, if you take 72 and divide it by your rate of return, in this case 8%, what does that end up being? Somewhere in the neighborhood of, 9 years? So we're doubling our money every 9 years. Not bad. Not bad at all. Now, since 2009, it's been a very different picture. You can see on the chart here that the market has enjoyed one of the nicest bull runs in history. The market is now up over 300% since 2009. Now, I want you to think about this. I'm sure some of you watching this have money in the stock market, maybe own a portfolio of stocks, or you have mutual funds, and you're sitting there scratching your head going, wait a second, I'm in the market. I'm not up 300%. What's the deal? Well, that's your signal. You're not getting the returns that you ought to. By the way, that would be a rate of return based on no skill whatsoever. If you simply bought the S&P 500 through, say, an ETF like the SPY and sat on it for the last 10 years, you'd have made 300% on your money. And some of you have your money placed with advisors and brokers and mutual funds and managed accounts and so forth. You're like, man, I'm not even scratching that. Most of you have probably not even doubled your money. So if the market provided 300%, and you've made 100% or 200%, what happened to all the rest of that money? Here's the answer. It ended up in somebody else's pocket. Now, many of you watching this, you have nothing in the market. Your money was sitting in the bank, making zero or close to zero. And here's my question to you. Are you getting tired of missing it? Hearing all the other people making all the money. And you may say, well, you know, I'm not in the stock market because I don't have enough money. Look, if you have enough money to have a checking account and you have enough money to have a savings account, you've got enough money to be in the stock market. It doesn't take any more amount of money. You can go open an account and start it with a dollar if you wanted to. And you'd be amazed when you start compounding money, what happens over time, which is the subject of another one of our lessons. So look, I want to encourage you, get started. Nobody has ever looked back on their life and said, I wish I would have started later. Everybody says, I wish I started earlier. If you're sick of missing it, let me tell you when you'll do something about it. When you get sick enough. When that pain threshold gets to a level where you say, that's it. Nobody saves their way to financial security. Nobody. The only way to get there is through savvy, intelligent investing, using the kind of strategies that you'll learn by watching my YouTube channel. So for those of you who are not subscribers, just go ahead and subscribe now. If you want the alerts, click on the notification bell, and every time I post something new, you'll be notified. So until next time, have an awesome day. God bless everybody. Prosperous trading.